We begin with Joseph Jean Arthur Béliveau. I was a kid when this happened, so there can't be a tape of it anywhere, and my memory might be playing tricks on me, but I don't think so. The living masterpiece of the National Hockey League had retired nearly two seasons before, but he was still a regular at the games of the Montreal Canadiens at the fabled Forum on St. Catherine Street, and one night during the 1972-73 season, he was interviewed, between periods, on the New York Rangers telecast of their game at Montreal. The Forum was an old building. There were no TV facilities, basically, and those intermission interviews were often done from the players' benches. The interviewee that night was Béliveau, a man who could only be described as stately. He would later be courted for high office by Canada's Liberal Party and by Canada's Conservative Party. But Béliveau was not imperious, he was imperial. Dignity, class, ease of motion, soft-spokenness, but with a winning smile and a sense of humor about himself and no ego. And that night, in retirement, between periods of the Rangers-Canadiens game, standing in the bench, the Zamboni repeatedly crossing between his face and the camera, I learned just how complete his lack of ego was. The interviewer that night was the Rangers color announcer, an almost equally wonderful man named Bill the Big Whistle Chadwick. Chadwick had been a linesman and referee for 16 NHL seasons, universally acclaimed the best, inventor of the hand signals for penalties, and later revealing he had done it all while secretly blind in his right eye. And he was from here in New York, and he sounded like Walter Matthau, or like members of my family from the Bronx. And he said things like, "Mom, Gene Carr couldn't put the puck in the ocean if he was standing on the pier." And Bill Chadwick had known Jean Béliveau since Béliveau almost unwillingly broke in with the Canadiens in 1950, and the respect they had for one another was total and immediately obvious to everyone. But Chadwick was in his first year on television. He was still a little nervous, and for whatever reason, when the red light went on and he was standing next to what was obviously, to anybody who had 1 minute's worth of hockey knowledge, Jean Béliveau, Bill Chadwick said, "So, I'm here with the Montreal Canadian great, Jean Béliveau. How are you, Jean?" Jean Béliveau. Without missing a beat, Jean Béliveau smiled warmly and sincerely and said, "What a pleasure it is to see you, my old friend Bill," and reminded people what a great referee Chadwick had been, and wished his old friends and old opponents back in New York well, and mentioned a few reporters and the Rangers coach, and the interview proceeded in that fashion. And when Bill Chadwick got the cue to wrap it up, he said something like, "It's always an honor to be the referee in one of your games. It's an honor to talk to you now, Jean Béliveau. Thank you, Jean." And Jean Béliveau embraced Chadwick, and then they went to commercial. Jean Béliveau scored 507 goals and another 79 in the playoffs, and he set up another 809 total, and his name is inscribed on the Stanley Cup as a player 10 times, and he was an executive on 7 more Stanley Cup winners, and it's true, when he retired, they waived the waiting period and immediately elected him and Gordie Howe to the Hall of Fame, and it's true that when trying to explain to uninformed Americans who he was in Canada, the best analogy is Joe DiMaggio, but with modesty and a sense of humor. And it's true when he was playing for the Citadel de Quebec and the Oz de Quebec, the Quebec Aces, his hometown team in the semi-professional Quebec Senior League. He tried to avoid leaving his hometown to go play for Montreal and was rewarded with a contract larger than he would have gotten from Montreal. And so the Montreal front office solved their problem by simply buying the entire Quebec Senior League and making it a full-time professional league, and thus forcing Béliveau to go to the NHL. And it's true, in the 80s, the Conservative Prime Minister tried to get him into Canada's Senate, and he said, "No, thank you." And it's true, in 1994, the Liberal Prime Minister arranged to have him appointed as the Governor General of Canada, the official representative of the Queen of England to her country's former territory, to make him the 25th Governor General of Canada, when the 6th Governor General of Canada had been Lord Stanley of Preston, who is the Stanley from the Stanley Cup. And it's true, even with all that, he also said then, "No thank you," so he could stay closer to his family. All of that is true, and all of that speaks to the walking, skating definition of class that was Jean Béliveau, who died last night at the age of 83. But to me, who Jean Béliveau was sealed that night 40 and more years ago when he was introduced on live television as Jean Béliveau. And he did nothing but thank the interviewer and smile and wish all of us hockey fans back here in New York the best.